Hi, everyone. This is Joanna. Welcome to Moon Water Tarot. And I am going on a little vacation, but you are coming along with me. I am taking you to a place that I have been going to for a little over 20 years. And it is a place where there has been a lot of tragedy, but in my heart, it also has, I have a strong kinship with it. And for me, it brings back some very positive memories. So I felt compelled to go back there. I go there, you know, every so often and stay the night. So that's what we're going to do. I'm not really going there to do any tarot readings, but just share with you what I pick up and show you the place. And I do a few readings there, but it's very difficult with the energy. So I had an incident happen prior to going, and I wanted to share it with you. You'll see while I'm packing with Nicholas. Hi, everybody. This is Joanna, and I wanted to let you know that we are going on location. So I am so excited, and the funniest thing happened with Nicholas, so I just wanted to share it with you when I went and got my suitcase. I turn around, I open up the suitcase, and I literally go in the other room. About 3 minutes later, I come back out and look at what I see. I couldn't stop laughing. There's little Nicholas. Nicholas, he's looking at something. What are you looking at? Nicholas. Anyway, I think what he's telling me is that he wants to go with me on the trip. So I just had to share this with you. I wish he would look. Nicholas, what's over there? Come here. Say hi. Was that a little orb? Did you see an orb again? We've been seeing a lot of orbs, so lots of angels and protection for us. So I'm very happy about that. Anyway, so just wanted to share this with you. I just thought it was so cute. All right, I'll talk to you soon. Bye. Say bye, Nicholas. Say bye.
Hi, everybody. We are here. We are at our location. This is the world-renowned Lemp Mansion Restaurant and Inn in Benton Park, Missouri, and that's in St. Louis. And I wanted to tell you, I was outside shooting this, and there was a highway nearby, and with these roads and the street noise, it was so noisy. I had to re-record the sound, so I apologize. I'm going to take you on a little tour around the side, and then we're going to go inside, and we are staying the night. As I stated, I do come here frequently, and one night I did have the entire place to myself. Charles Lemp actually woke me up at 5 in the morning. I don't know if anything will happen, but this has I have a special kinship with the place, and I just felt compelled to go back and wanted to share it with you. I have subscribers and people I read for all over the world that will never get an opportunity to see this place, so I wanted to share it with you. So I will tell you just briefly a little bit about the history, but you can go to their website, lempmansion.com, and learn more accurate details and facts than what I may give you, because I'm just doing this kind of off the cuff here, but basically Adam Lemp came from Germany and started his own brewing company. And when he passed, William Lemp Sr. inherited the brewery, met Julie and got married, and they had 10 children. And, oh, I just wanted to point out on the left there, I believe that's St. Agatha's Church. And as we pan up the house, just look at those tiny little rectangle windows at the very top. That's called the eaves, and that will have some importance later. William Sr. ended up committing suicide in this house because his fourth son, Frederick, was his favorite. And Frederick died at the age of 28 of a heart ailment that they were not aware of. He was so devastated, he killed himself here. By default, the oldest son, Billy, William Jr., ends up inheriting the brewery, but with Prohibition, loses everything. It ends up getting liquidated. At one point, it was worth $7 million, and I think it sold for about $588,500. And so, also, his sister Elsa, in another location, ends up committing suicide. That was questionable whether it was a suicide or a murder. William Jr. then commits suicide in this house, and then his older brother Charles, who's very despondent and reclusive, he shoots his dog Serba, who is a Doberman Pinscher, and then kills himself in this house also. So three suicides of the Lemp family in this house, a fourth one outside of the house, which is questionable, but very sad, and a lot of tragedy in this family. This is the beautiful lobby, and I had recorded this live. I'm redoing the sound because when I played back this video, I saw an animal. Just let me know if you see the animal, and I will leave it at that. You're going to see quite a few orbs go by, but there's an animal that makes its presence twice. And so I did not see it when I was recording it, but as I play it back, I'm seeing it. And so just wanted to see if anybody else picked up on it. But this is the beautiful entrance and the steps that lead up to the main floor. All right. Okay, so we are on the second level, and right where this table is straight ahead, that's where the William room is, which is the room I'm staying in, and then you can see the lobby down below with the staircase. So this is the second level, and the lavender room is right there. And then I'm just panning across, and there is a hallway where I'm pointing there, where that's where my bathroom is, down that hallway. So it's not even in my room. And there, we just passed the lavender room. So just wanted to give you an idea of the second level. So this is my room. This is where William Sr., sadly committed suicide, was in this room. And normally I would stay in the Charles room, which is down the hall. That's now been turned into a lounge. I've never stayed in this actual room before. I would always stay in Charles's room. But as you can see, this is a beautiful room, very big. There's pocket doors there. My understanding is at one point, after the Lemps lost the mansion or everything got liquidated, another couple, not the current owners, other couple bought it, and it was a boarding house for about 20 years. And that's why the pocket doors divided this room into different apartments. Now, during that time, I believe there was also some tragedy that happened in this building. So it's not just the Lemps that went through hard and devastating times, but
but other people did also. The Lemps were not the ones that actually built the house. It was, I believe, already built and they bought it. Those are my crystals that I brought with me also for protection, of course. But I just wanted to share where I was staying the night with you here so you could see the beautiful room.
So here we are on the roof deck. It's very noisy, but I'm just trying to do like a 180 or 360 here. We'll see how it goes, but we're on the roof deck. People are not normally out here. There's that church that I was talking about, and I don't know if you can see, but in the far distance there, over there, there's Anheuser-Busch, which there's the highway. Okay, I just wanted to share this with you because people normally aren't out here, but I got very lucky today. All right, and that's looking down on the garden. Okay, we're gonna go back inside. Thanks.
This is the eaves, those little windows that I was talking to you about to look up. I will be returning here at nighttime, which is even more extraordinary, the activity that is going on up here. And this really is affiliated with Zeke, the child who died at approximately the age of 16. And he supposedly was born with some disabilities and possibly, my understanding is, a disfigurement and was made fun of. And so this was the area where he stayed most. And I will get into that a little bit later. Most people will never see this during the day. There is a tour that you can take Monday evenings that will take you out in the night. And but I got very lucky and I got to see it during the daylight, and then you'll see it again at nighttime. So I'll be back with this scene. So on the second level, straight ahead is the lavender room through this doorway. But this, so there's three rooms. Now they turned this room into a lounge area. This is where I stayed by myself. This is Charles's room. He did not commit suicide in this room, but this is where he lived as a recluse most of the time. And this is where I stayed by myself, that couch. There was a bed there. And at 5 a.m, I got woken up with Charles Lemp leaning over me when I was here by myself.
We are in the parlor, and I'm going to try and get the ceiling in because it's all been hand painted here, but I just wanted to show it to you. And there's two fireplace mantles, and you can see one further down to the right, and that's African mahogany, which is extremely difficult to find, is what they told me, and I'm sure quite expensive also. So, but it's just amazing. Beautiful wood. Look at that. So I just wanted to share that with you. It goes all the way up.
So here we are on the main level, and this is such a beautiful bathroom. This is an Italian marble that Mr. Lemp picked up from a hotel, I believe it was in Italy, and brought it all the way over and put it in this bathroom. So just wanted to share this with you, this amazing bathroom with these gigantic, huge ceilings. So it's quite remarkable.
Okay, so this is a view from the staircase. Very beautiful. And a lot, I think almost all, the lamps or the chandeliers are original and very much of the Art Deco period. So this is where William Lemp Jr. unfortunately committed suicide. And after some time, what they did is they turned this into an office, and this became William's office right around, I believe it was the Prohibition period. But there's so many facts to learn, but I just wanted to share with you the space here. And that beautiful fireplace too, because I know that they said that this is original, if I remember correctly.
So here we are, and you can see all this activity. This is the eaves, those little windows. Remember, we were here during the day, so it's like an L shape, and I think it goes all the way around the house on the top, but it's those little windows, and my understanding is that one of the Lemps had an illegitimate child, and by the name of Zeke. I believe he was born in 1904, and he died approximately in 1920. There isn't a lot of information or records is what I was told, but that he was born with disabilities and was made fun of and called horrible names. And so now what I was also told is back then to not only have an illegitimate child, but then to have one with disabilities, and these are not my words, but back then it was looked down upon. So they kept him up here. And this was the most difficult area for me personally to be in. It just felt very, very sad. And this was on, I was able to come back in the nighttime with, they have a Monday night tour, and I'm doing a re-recording the sound because you could hear people talking in the background. It was a little distracting, and so that's why it's re-recorded. But I, you know, definitely was sending, it seemed like the more I tried to send love and, you know, that type of energy, I noticed that whenever I did that, the orbs would really pick up. And but that's what I tried to do. But they do have a Monday night tour, and it's like a 2-hour tour of of most of the mansion. And they do, give you this access. I was just lucky to have it both in the day and the nighttime, but you can come up here, and I think it's on their website. It's like from 7 to 9. Sometimes it goes a little bit longer. But yeah, this is when I was really sending a lot of positive, loving energy, and I just a burst of orbs. So anyway, so just wanted to share this area with you. It's probably one of the most active places. There were quite a other places too, but yeah, so this is where Zeke's area was, sadly. Okay. Thank you.
So this is one of three vaults in the Lemp mansion. And there is so much activity here. I wanted to get a picture also of this chair. This is an old wedding chair gift. I hope you can see it. It's original. But this is, they've turned this into a shop. It's kind of hard to see that though.
So this is the bathroom that I used. It was not attached to my room. It's a beautiful bathroom, but I did have to walk down the hallway to get to it, quite a bit of ways. I'm sorry, the camera is so jiggly, but I did want to kind of capture the bathroom. It's very beautiful. And I will show you what happened to me as I walk down the hallway next. So I was going back to my room from the bathroom and look at what emanates from the ground on up. That. And that looked like a piece of string, and I assure you it was not a piece of string. And look at all these orbs coming upward. I had my flash on in my camera, and that's why I was able to see this and catch everything on film. But this is a lot of activity. So this is a shot at night with in my room that I was staying in. Yeah, that was a pretty big orb that just went by there. So this is where William Sr. did commit suicide, was here in this room where I'm staying. So I did catch quite a bit of activity here. So I thought that I would leave my room and go to another area, and this is what I encountered. This is on the staircase on the way down.
So this is the atrium. I hope it's kind of dark. And you might hear some people talking in the background, but I wanted to show you this is the original floors. They said from the 1800s. But Mrs. Lemp loved animals, and the ceiling was all in glass.
So I got very lucky. This is the interior of the attic, and you can see part of the eaves that's going to be coming up later here. I got lucky in that there was Kelly and Dennis were staying in the lavender room across from my room. Very nice people, and we were up in the attic, and they were focusing on energy, and I happened to be filming, and you will see here, one of the things we noticed is even on the tour, we turned off all our cell phones, all the lights. We were in pitch black, like pitch darkness, and we would see what almost looked like lightning bugs. Just like little, they weren't quite orbs. They were these little light features, like, and there's one that comes in, see, comes in right now, right above Dennis's head, and then it floats like a little lightning bug. And when it goes away, there's little eyes there. I don't know if you saw it. Now it's back again in the mirror. And then it floats away out, and there goes another, like a little set of animal's eyes. And at the time, she was asking about any animals, because I know that the Lemps had a lot of animals. Julia Lemp had, I think, either 6 or 9 cats and lots of birds that she kept in that atrium. And then, of course, Charles had his dog that he had with him. I believe it was a Doberman. So right when she asked about animals, that's when that kind of lightning bug, and then you see a set of eyes appear. We also got EVPs. I heard a dog barking earlier, and then right after that, we saw a silhouette of a dog. This is the open area of the eaves that you can just, you know, it's not blocked off like the other area. But then Dennis and I audibly and on our cameras caught an EVP. It was definitely a male's voice, and he went, mm-hmm. I don't even know. It was so, you can see that in the sound wave on the video. I don't have any expert equipment. I mean, this is like my cell phone that I'm doing here. So, but I'm sure when I looked at the sound wave, you could see dead silence, and then you hear a mm-hmm. And Dennis looked at me and said, "Did you hear that?" And I heard it before before he even acknowledged it, I had heard it. See, there's the bug comes back again. It just shot back there again. And so, and there were quite a few of those. So anyway, but this is the central attic area. And so I wanted to share that with you, because the eaves goes all around this part. And there are, I think, 2 or 3 bedrooms up here, at least 2 that you can stay in. All right.
And so this is the lavender room. I'm trying to show you the top, too. There's so much activity here. That's the top. As you can see, the chandelier. And it just goes on into a whole nother area. So you can see, but it's just gorgeous.
There's a huge orb that just went in. This was the lavender room again. This had a lot of activity, and the next clip is also going to be showing quite a bit of activity going on here too. And this is still the lavender room. This is where Dennis and Kelly were staying, and just there's so many images that I had, because at one point, I mean, I've shot so much video, I'm just showing you some of it. It just felt like orbs were just flying like crazy, almost like there was a vortex or something that really was allowing them to move so freely in here. And so I wanted to share this with you. Luckily, this room was open, and that they were staying in here. We ended up, you know, spending a lot of the whole evening together. And because normally what happens when you rent out a room, if another room's not rent out, the doors are locked. You don't have access to it. So we got very lucky, and I shot in their room and they shot in mine. So just wanted to kind of share this with you. And okay.
All right, everybody. So this is the end of the tour. I'm here. It's very quiet. I'm lying in bed, getting ready for sleep, hopefully. And I'm just shooting to see if anything is flying above. And of course, you're seeing all these orbs fly here. That was a big one. So hopefully I'll get some sleep. This bed is very comfortable, so I'm hoping that will help. Yeah, there was a tiny little one there. So you'll probably see some periodically. And once again, this is the Lemp mansion, and the room I stayed in was the William room. So, wow, still so much activity. I'm not even sure what time it is right now. I think it's probably 4 in the morning. So, and there's a little something there. I don't know what that is. It's almost like one of those lightning bugs, but it's not as strong. Just a little light of some kind. I don't know. You can see it on. There it is. Anyway, so I hope you enjoyed the tour. Thank you so much for watching, and take care. Have a good night. All right. Bye.